Today, the COVID-19 pandemic has left us with surging levels of poverty and inequality that we must overcome as soon as possible.
We have the pandemic, we have the fourth industrial revolution, we have the expansion of diversity, inequity in the world, we have weaknesses in democracy, and of course, these are new challenges for the future.
But hopefully the health crisis will spur governments, businesses, and civil society actors to find ways to work together more effectively and invest in health and education systems that have been shown to be deficient.
It is incumbent of all of us to construct a new normal that delivers opportunity at all levels of society. We should be capable of driving the green transformation upon which the health of our planet depends. We ought to create more economic mobility and economic opportunity for all, as well as more accountability.
No debemos dejar atrás las dolorosas lecciones aprendidas, ni postergar más las reformas requeridas para blindar mejor a nuestras economías y democracias ante crisis como la sufrida.
We need to establish also just a predictable and effective way to respond to new migration events. And that means making sure that we have a coordinated approach and a common set of understandings when it comes to refugees and asylum responsibilities that we have as a region.
En su momento más álgido, más de 160 millones de niños, niñas y jóvenes quedaron sin clases presenciales. Y aún hoy, después de casi dos ciclos escolares completos, según datos de UNICEF, permanecen cerca de 80 millones de estudiantes en esta situación.
Creo que hemos aprendido también que hay mucho potencial para continuar mejorando estas tecnologías. No debemos, a mi entender, pensar que la respuesta que hubo de educación remota es la mejor respuesta que podemos tener en educación mediada por tecnología. No es la mejor, es una respuesta de emergencia.
Temas de corto plazo muy fundamentales se han tocado acá. El primero es el de las vacunas. Es muy difícil tener una recuperación sin que haya una vacunación amplia.
La economía china, que fue la primera en salir de la pandemia, obviamente también la primera en entrar, salió con mucha fuerza, un PIB que creció un 18% el primer trimestre del 2021, está mostrando gran debilidad.
Una buena estrategia de vacunación con buenas vacunas, efectivas, seguras, es la salida para que comiencen nuevamente a abrirse actividades económicas, generar empleo, el aumento de la demanda, el consumo.
Debemos entender que no habrá justicia ambiental sin justicia financiera global y sin justicia social global.
And also be able to have sustainable business, sustainable production, and be able to have the mantra in society of reduce, reuse, recycle.
By all measures, by all indicators, our region has been the hardest hit by this pandemic.
Realmente el impacto en el desempleo de las mujeres, en países incluso que nos recuperamos mucho más aceleradamente de lo que empezábamos, de lo que esperábamos, tiene un impacto y está dejando una cantidad de mujeres fuera de los mercados de trabajo.
And the hard truth, the hard and difficult truth that must be said is that only 23% of all measures are actually gender sensitive.
I think there's widespread agreement today that democracy in much of Latin America and the Caribbean is deeply troubled. Increasingly, we hear analysts, journalists, advocates, and polls that point to deterioration in the strength of democratic institutions and practices, and a weakening in the rule of law.
There is clearly, at this current stage, no functional reasonable and rational debate about how Brazil can overcome many of its challenges, also many of the challenges induced by the pandemic. But there are clearly a lot of rising political actors on these subnational levels, which are promising and which deserve our support.
So I'm going to talk about very quickly about the five tendencies that keep me awake at night, which are centralization and hyper-presidentialism, deinstitutionalization, and this is different from Brazil because you do see checks and balances that continue to survive in Brazil, while in Mexico they are being weakened deliberately by the federal government. The third would be militarization, pauperization, and pauperización, and polarization.
Addressing the challenges of climate change can also help recovery from this terrible pandemic which has faced the world. So we look forward to working with all countries in this region to move forward. But the issues are urgent. The science is telling us climate change is not only happening now, many countries in this region are living the reality, but it's happening with greater urgency, with greater impact than any of us ever envisaged.
In terms of energy, Latin America has abundant renewable energy. So the region should make a strong effort to shift to a much lower carbon energy by 2030.
Over the years of 2004 to 2014, we had the chance to decrease 80% of the deforestation in the Brazilian Amazon.
Con liderazgos visionarios y un renovado espíritu de diálogo y cooperación regional, nada nos impide soñar como una próxima década de oportunidades que siente las bases de un desarrollo dinámico, inclusivo, verde e inteligente.